I don't like that name. Yup. Alright.
It's the same sign as before.
Yeah. This one might actually have to be completed next time. I don't even know where to start here. I'm gonna check that one ledge, though, because that ledge was pretty freaking bad. I'll at least try to get partially up there, and then we can tell. No. Yeah, no coins in the level. Oh, and we've got amps. My freaking favorite. Oh man, I'm having some flashbacks to the Bowser in the sky level. I freaking hate those things so much. No! Get the fuck away. I don't like you. God, there's no time. There is no time. There is no time. There is no time. There is no time. There was no time. Oh, that is actually quite a bit easier. Okay. Make it up. No. This amp is gonna mess up everything. This angle here. Okay. Again, no idea if this is even the right place to go, but this has been the most difficult thing in the level so far, so I feel like it probably is. Let's see. I don't see a star up there. Let me do a couple attempts at this jump. I'm not going to spend a huge amount of time here, hopefully. Oh my god. Okay. This has got to be it, right? No, no, there's still nothing up here. What was the point of that ledge? Why do you put in a barely reachable ledge and not have anything on it? That really, really bothers me. Unless that has to do something with, like, the DLC pack. I don't know. Wait, really? Was that actually it? It was. What the hell? How was that... Why? Is the rest of the level just gone? No, it's there. Oh, wait. Okay, I think I get this. Hold on. When you do star 6, you can replay star 1, 2, or 4. That was star 1. Does that mean that the other ones are also in here? That's gonna account for those missing secret stars that I didn't know where they were. So this level actually has 9 stars then? Am I understanding this right? Which was number 2? That was the box jumping. I think I can get to that from here. What was number 4? 4 was, I don't even remember. Okay, let's see if I can make this. I think there's gonna be star here, if I'm understanding this right. If I'm correct, then I don't really feel the need to show these on screen, honestly. No, I mean, I can. I'll just do it next time. Well, I already showed that one. And then this is going to be the second one. Yeah. Yeah, that... Okay. The sign did not word it very well at all. But that is what's happening here. So there's this one. There's the one on the clock. And then, yeah, that's that. Okay, that one, I'll show that one on screen next time. Or, you know what, fuck it, I'll just do it now. It's not gonna take that long. The one on the clock, I'm not gonna bother collecting on screen, because I already got it and then reloaded the save state, plus it's really easy. But, this one shouldn't be so bad. It's kind of an interesting mechanic, I guess. Oh, for God's sake. Come on. I've never seen a main stage with more than 6 stars before, so that's... or 7, I guess, but... I wonder if that just means that this, like, doesn't count as part of the same stage then, or, like, they're kind of secret stars. I don't know, it's kind of weird. I'll have to check how that looks on the stat screen once I get this one. No. Now? So what, this is going to be the third time I'm grabbing this one on screen? Or going through this whole section? And yeah, that ledge really should have had something on it. I still am not sure what to make of that thing. That ledge was the final boss. And the fact that I actually made that the second time, like, on my first attempt, was... I don't even know what. I guess it was just the angle really mattered. And I didn't have the right angle the first time. But that was... You could tell how bad that was. That was on par with that junk I had to do in level 12, I think it was. No, 13. The one with, like, the big castle and stuff. Where I had to, like, go up the ice waterfall. That was some... I don't even know. There was the 5 one-ups. They weren't wrong. Wait, what? Hold on, what? I think I misunderstood again. I take back everything I said. Give me a second here. I gotta confirm. No, just make the jump. Come on, it's not that hard. See, this is what happens when messages are not very clear. And again, English isn't his first language. I can't really fault him for that, but he should have had, like, somebody check it or something. Yeah, okay. So, what's actually happening here is Star 6 appears in 3 places simultaneously. So, why you would choose to get anything but Star number 1, I have no idea, but I've now gotten all 3 of them, so good for me, I guess. Yelpsy Pie and Hippity Poo, kick him in the dishpan. There we go. So anyway, here we have, again, here's level 15, which is Shredded Worlds in Blue. And then we have whatever is in this one. I am missing 9 stars, presumably 7 of them are in there. I'm actually going to see what this is first. Oh, what the hell? What is this madness? Let's take a second there, and from what I saw of that, it was just some kind of 16-bit remake. I do want to actually try to read the sign, though. Hey, you nearly beat the game. Now stand here in front of the sign, and you will ascend to a little bonus level. Which I'm... What is this pattern on the floor? Because that looked really creepy for a second. I don't know. I'm hoping there's two stars in here. It's a 3D version of Yoshi's Island 1. So yeah, again, hoping that there's a... Okay, well, we got red coins. That's at least something. Suppose this is somewhat interesting. It's at least not the first level of the original Mario, which is ridiculously overdone. This is the first level of a different Mario. It is slightly less overdone. I can't get up the pipe. Level's unbeatable. Alright, so... really hoping that there's more than the 8 red coins, because if there's not, then that means there's a mysterious other star somewhere in the game, and it is very possible that there is one, but I wouldn't even know where to begin looking for that, so... with luck, there's nothing else that I'm missing, but I guess we'll find out. Now how will I possibly get inside this? Even though I can very obviously go in through the side. Also, it probably doesn't actually lead to anything. Had to see if that did anything. It wasn't a spin jump, though, so it didn't count. Nope, not even a warp. Okay. So yeah, pretty much decided I was just gonna do this level instead of the other one because I figured it would probably be better to close on the other one. I don't know. No real reason. I guess it could go either way. I don't know why I just keep trying to climb these pipes. It's not like there's anything on top of them. So, I have decidedly not looked up anything on the, like, extra DLC pack thing for this game, because, again, I do know it exists. I just don't know anything about it. I do... definitely at least want to try it. It's just a... Oh, that's kind of interesting then. Didn't activate the yellow switch palace. Does this give me a message? No. Yeah, I'm curious how that whole thing works. I know that you have to just get like a patch basically and play on a file that has all 120 stars or something. I don't really know. So, like I said, I'll worry about that later on. Main question is what I'm going to do once I'm done with this game, because I have been having fun playing through it, and other people seem to be enjoying it, so I would not be opposed to doing another hack. I'm just not sure if that is the best choice, or if I should figure out something completely unrelated, because I think I'm going to be doing the Pokemon Platinum thing when Paper Mario is done. I don't really want to have two RPGs running at the same time. I mean, Pokemon is only an RPG by, like, the loosest terms, because it's really not... I don't know. It's obviously not story-based, and it's more just going to be a challenge with the stupid, like, team that I'm planning on using, but... it's still two kind of slow turn-based games, and yeah. Alright, let's see where... last one is. There is that area up there. I'm just not sure if I need to get up there quite yet. This music is excellent, by the way. Oh, well, there's the last red coin. So I guess I'll just grab that then. And yeah, there's no regular star here, so... that does worry me a bit. I will come back to check that higher area to see if there's any way to get up there. Yeah, because I don't know where the hell the other one would be. I haven't really seen any comments on it either. I don't think I've been actually reading every single comment, but I mean, I've been pretty good about it, keeping up with them, and... there are a fair number of people who either have looked up stuff on this game or started playing it at the same time as me or whatever, and usually fill me in on stuff I've missed. Didn't see anything else for this, though. So, I don't know. Guess we'll find out. So, I'm just gonna basically find out if there's, anything up... Oh, good job. Like, I'm not sure how I would get up there anyway, but I imagine it's gotta be possible through some kind of, like, overly precise triple jump bullshit. So, I'm gonna try my best to do that. And that was not a slope, so I couldn't do anything there. Alright, let's get rid of the Goombas. Alright, again, I could probably just look up there and see, but I want to see how feasible this is first. There's a one-up up there, at least. I mean, that's what was there in the original game. Lord. Is this even possible for me to triple jump on something this small? It's pretty damn small, I'm not sure. Once again, excellent freaking music. And if I do a side flip, that's not gonna be enough, right? No. I don't think there's anything up there, though. It doesn't really look like it. Other than the one-up, obviously. So, let me get a good look at it from here. No, it doesn't really look like it. I think that's just there because it's there on the original level. Well, shit. I guess we'll see what the next place looks like. After I take one last tour through the castle. And actually, this is a good time to also look around and make sure there's nothing that I've missed. Because, I mean, I know that I've got the full amount of stars from every one of these levels. And yeah, just 14 secrets. And, I think I've been pretty thorough with checking everything. Whatever, let's just, I'm not... Oh, I don't actually want to be here, never mind. My bad. Alright, let's, actually go through the correct door this time. Come on. No. So, I guess we'll see what this, shredded blue, dripping yellow madness, I don't know what the hell the level was called. Something strange. Okay, there we go. I'm not sure how these level, how this video is gonna like space out in terms of like time management. Shredded worlds in blue. Well, can't see a whole lot yet. There's a tower. There's some kind of dripping yellow madness up there. Blue realm is still a bit broken. New star. I'm assuming that's a different hack. Well, as always, let's begin the coin collecting. No. Off to a beautiful start. And do we have to get flipped places by heave-hoes? Because that's not exactly my favorite pastime. Don't really care for level design that involves that. It's okay once in a while, it's just, it's one of the more annoying things to have to deal with. So yeah, unless there's just an eighth star in this level somewhere, then I don't know. But I will try my best to stop worrying about that so much, and instead just focus on what's going on here. Well, if I was a level designer, I would be a dick and hide something behind this, so let's find out. Doesn't look like it. Nope. Nope, nothing there. Nothing on that side, okay. Camera obstruction, yay! I get up here and I have found a yellow cube. And there's just kind of a star here. Is this actually star number one? Because it did say climb the small tower. I'm not sure if this is the small one or not. It's hard to judge if I haven't seen any others yet. Yep, well, we know where that one is then. Not gonna be grabbing that now. I have 17 whole coins. I can't possibly lose those. So, I'm just gonna let this play out here. Okay, so I guess that's it for this place. I will definitely make a note that there is a star up there. I'll have to be coming back. But yeah, I figure we'll just want to get the coin collecting out of the way as usual, so continue doing that. So we had the idea for this area after playing New Star. I'm not quite sure what the thematic, like, well, I guess just theme, not even thematic, just what the theme of this place is supposed to be, other than, like, narrow platforms and kind of like an ethereal, I don't know. What do we have over yonder? We have bad camera angles, excellent. I haven't ever seen those before. And I made the jump anyway. Not terribly impressed with this place so far. Feel like there's been more interesting and more difficult levels that I've already been through. This pipe leads to a boss fight. Okay. I suppose that works. Let's see what kind of boss fight. Excellent music, and we just have Womp Kang. A Mario. Why am I transparent? Oh, no, actually. Yeah, invincibility is spelled right there, I think. Unless I'm misreading it. I'm surprised. But anyway. Oh, what the hell? There's just a Kappa face. Okay, anyway, I'm not gonna actually fight him yet. That's pretty great, though. That reminds me, I never did go back to that Super Metroid Randomized. Because I did a stream of that once, and I got a reserve tank, and it was just a Kappa face. And it was kinda great. And can I please just get the red coin? Thank you. Okay, yeah, this level is definitely starting to branch out a bit more. It's a little difficult to tell where I've been and where I haven't. Well, here's, two or three red coins right in close proximity. Okay, just two. Thought I saw a third one. What is this shit here? Oh, yeah, that's quicksand, okay. Couldn't really tell. Seeing as how it's, like, dark blue. I guess that's what the statues are there for, to indicate that it's doom sand. No. Really? Why is there an invisible wall? I'm offended by your sensibilities. I'm noticing that I have a really, really shitty commentary for this one. I'm not sure why that is. will mention that I've been messing around more with Mario Maker. I still have not made anything other than that one level, which, again, has not been shown on screen yet or anything, but it exists. I've mentioned that I made it before. I do have plans for another. I'm just not sure if it's feasible, and I don't want to say anything about it yet. Because I pretty much want all my levels to be either really gimmicky or just noteworthy in some fashion. Like, when it comes to playing that game, and like playing other people's levels, I have gotten to the point where basically I will give a star to anything that kind of resembles a level. And unfortunately, there's not very many of those. At least when doing like the 100 Mario challenge. Because I've gone through easy enough time to get all the costumes from that. I'm working on normal right now. And if I'm lucky, I'll get like one, maybe two actual levels per playthrough. When I say actual levels, I basically mean anything that isn't just kind of a pile of random shit thrown together. It has to have some kind of cohesive, like, theme to it, or at least not just be like, ye find yeself in yon dungeon, here's 500 stars and a bunch of enemies, and some random disjointed platforms, and then like a wall of note blocks. Like, I don't consider those levels. So, basically what I want to say here is, there's, like, I don't have extremely high standards when it comes to that game, and there's nothing wrong with people who just make kind of regular levels that you get to the end, you win, there's no gimmick, as long as it's put together well. But, I don't want to, like, whore myself out for upvotes, so, like, I'm still gonna probably be stuck with the 10-level limit. Unless, like, I actually do make good stuff and deserve the stars that I get, so that's why for every one of them I want to make them, like, noteworthy in some way. Again, I eventually will do a video showing off what I've made, but I'll want to have more than one level before I do that. Is this thing down here? Have I been in here already? Yeah, it's so hard to tell what I've done. I'll remember that that's there then. Oh, it just leads out here, okay. So, what does the switch do? There's a box. There's some more boxes. Yep, those are definitely boxes. So is this stuff quicksand or is this lava? This is lava. Okay, that's actually better. Because at least it does not kill you instantly. Oh yeah, and speaking of Mario Maker, there's a update coming out tomorrow, I think, which is going to have checkpoints, and I don't know what else. So, I will have to see what that introduces before I start putting together anything new, because I'll probably want to make use of whatever's in there. And what do we have here? Well, we have another star, which I will grab and see which one it is. Investigate a fort. I don't know why that made me laugh. It was just, like, I guess just the bluntness of it. Like, how do you get this star? Oh, you investigate a fort. Do you investigate the fort? No, just a fort. Alright. There is a block up there. Let's see, can I get all 5 coins from this guy? Yes, I can. Okay, cool. We are getting closer to the 100 coins. And falling off of blocks. And I'm sure there's a whole section at the bottom of the stage that I still have not gone to yet. I guess this is just like a way back. but I could get back anyway, so I don't know. Like, you can see that there's a sledge down here, but I'm pretty sure I've been on the sledge already. Because this is the one that just goes, yeah. I don't know. Just some kind of unnecessary return path, I suppose. Unless there's going to be something there on a later mission, which there probably will be. That was kind of amazing. Alright, let's figure out where I haven't been yet. I think it's back across the other end of the bridge. I want to say I've done everything over here, right? Yeah, pretty much looks like it. Okay. So, heading back. Is that a thing up there that I should be climbing on? If I could see, perhaps. It's... Nah, it's a slanty surface. Never mind. Good. Good job. Good. Okay. This looks like a place I haven't been to yet, so yeah. Let's, oh, that would be lava. Oh, well, there's where the red coin star appears. We'll attempt to remember this. Nope. Let's just go. Oh, wait. Haven't I done this already? Yeah, I think I came from... Let me just double check. Because there's been a fair amount of random platforming, and I think... Oh, for God's sake. I like how I managed to save that one. Alright. Yeah. I've been here. Okay. So, God, I don't remember what I've already done. Well, apparently I haven't done this part, so there's a start at least. Number 6, I thought I was on 7. Ugh. And here we have more bad camera angles, for one. This music's a little bit droning, too, I've gotta say. Come on, two more red coins. Am I gonna need you to bounce off of? What the hell was that? What can I get to if I bounce off here? In here, probably not much. Nope, doesn't really look like it. Now out there, I won't know because he decides to touch a wall and randomly die. Investigate a fort. Come on, stop that. I think I have more than enough coins, but I don't like losing them anyway. It's just kind of the principle of the thing. Okay, yep, if I can manage to get all of them from this guy... Oh my. Let's, get rid of that nuisance first. Oh, yeah, here, there's plenty of enemies. I don't even have to kill the Chukka. Alright, and there's yet another star. Alright. Oh. Yeah, like, don't accidentally grab the wrong one. Actually, you know what? I'm curious. What happens... I'm not going to save state to accidentally do this, because I do want to get the red coin star, but... What happens if you spawn the red coin star basically inside another one? I should be able to get a coin collection here that lets me do that. Ah, I don't... This one's appearing too low. No, wait, maybe... See, there's always going to be the... whichever one you touch the hitbox of first, I guess, is whichever you grab. Okay. I don't think there's a way to get both of them in one go. Here we go! Alright, so... Still need two red coins. And we know the locations of three other stars. And there are two that are still a mystery. And looking at the time, I think once I get the red coins, that'll actually probably be the end of this video, because I'm tacking on 10 minutes to the beginning of it, and I've almost recorded for 30 minutes now, so... Yeah, I'm not really sure what the next one's gonna include, other than just finishing up this one, and figuring out wherever the hell that last one is. Because there is still a random star somewhere unaccounted for. If you have ideas, let me know in the comments. I normally wouldn't want someone to flat out tell me the answer, but at this point I think it would probably be for the best if you did, so... I don't know. We'll see if I get comments on it. If I don't, then I can try to find it on my own. No! Pizza! Just pizza. I was gonna say pizza shit, and then it came out as pizza. No! Ugh, god damn it. This is excellent. No! Okay, there's one. Perhaps the other one is over here also. Not sure. There's just kind of some loan coins hanging around. Are these going to have hidden numbers on them? Because I have a feeling they are. Couldn't tell you why exactly, I just have a feeling. Yep! So now we know where a fourth one is. We've got the one at the beginning, the one at the... No, the one at a fort. The one at that long, twisty hallway. And then this one. Is the last red coin here, though, because I'm not really seeing it. Would be nice if it was, but I suppose that would be a bit too much. Oh, and then there's the Mop King. I forgot about him. So actually, that's probably everything, isn't it? Huh. That's kind of disappointing, then, if that's the case. So, honestly, I think at this point, I'm gonna try to get this coin, this star to spawn, because, I've shown the locations of the other ones on screen, and the next one can almost just be like a highlight video, and then focus on whatever else it is that I'm doing. So. Guess that'll work. Get rid of this guy, I don't need you. Now, these hidden numbers usually come in sets of five. I see where coin number four is. I don't see a fifth one. Can I even get this one? Maybe with the heave-ho. Or, no, I could just wall jump. Oh, wait. Did I see the red coin in the distance? I did. Okay, that's... That's very good. Where is the fifth yellow coin here? Because there is a fifth one, right? There's gotta be. Oh, it's just in the lava. Alright. I suppose that's a place to hide it. Hold on. I have 13 lives, 113 coins, and 113 stars. What the hell is this shit? I don't know what that means, but it's got to be significant in some way. So that was Coins of the Boxes. I guess that's a fairly literal title. And, let me head over here and try to find that red coin I spotted off in moonlight distance. Moonlight distance? No! Many combinations of this, I guess. I don't really know why I felt the need to quote Sonor Card Gauge there. I just, that sigh that I made reminded me of the sigh from Sonor Mort Gauge. So, I don't know. Where is... God, why? Where is that last red coin? Like, I can kind of tell where it is, but at the same time, not exactly. Just somewhere up there. Don't know how to get up there, so we get to fall in lava a bunch until I figure it out. Yeah, this is back to the beginning of the level. I don't need to go that way. This is a dead end. So yeah, this just kind of goes to the other part of the level. So I guess I'll grab that. Grab the red coin star, and then I'm assuming the Womp King is the last star. And I've shown all the others on screen that I can remember, so... Yeah. I've been kind of going over that in my head a million times and subjecting all of you to it a million times, so... I kind of apologize for that. Yeah, there was another coin here. Wait, no, what the hell? I saw it there to begin with. I just never got it. Wow, okay. I don't know. Apparently, I am somewhat losing my mind. And not remembering to save state when I need to. So, there we go. And it is right here. That's convenient of it. Here we go! Candy coins everywhere. Yeah, I suppose so. So, yeah. Next time I will be gathering the rest of these stars. I might as well just do it on screen, because otherwise it's going to be like 5 seconds long. And, let me close out of this so the music stops playing, because it's kind of loud. Recap of what all the secret stars in this game were, because I've got 14 of them. There were 5 outside the castle. One of them was in the pipe on the roof. One was from Red Coins. One was behind Bowser's castle. One was from flipping the house upside down. And one was inside the fireplace. That's 5. Then we have one from the Wiggler boss level. One from the Irock boss level. One from the slides in the toilet level. One from the Super Mario World level. That's at 4. And then there was 5 in the last Bowser stage, I think. There was one in the maze. There was one in the purple slidey place. There was one in the section you had to wall jump to, near the purple slidey place, like by using the cannon. There was one... Fuck, I don't remember. The video was like 2 weeks ago. It doesn't matter. I'm sure I got 5 there. But, so yeah, I think there's just one other one somewhere that's unaccounted for, and I will do a search of the castle and see what I can find, but I don't know. Like I said, if you have ideas, leave a comment. I'll email you a pizza roll or something. And I guess we'll check out the... I keep just calling it the DLC pack. It does have a name, I just don't remember what it's called. So yeah.